today. From AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, this is the National Football League. We'll see Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys taking on Joe Burrow and the Cincinnati Bengals.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and the very mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Obviously, they do everything big here in Dallas, and the introduction of the Cowboys, no exception. They're set for football in Big D as their guys will do battle with the Cincinnati Bengals. Get strapped in. It's just about time to get the party started. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. Brandon Wilson now from his end zone. And he returns this to the 22. Here are the Bengals on offense, and here is Joe Burrow ready to lead them at quarterback.
And when you come into the league as the number one guy selected, a lot of hype comes with it. And sometimes that weight can be unbearable. But this young man, he took that weight on and handled it as well as you can imagine. And I love his ability to make a second, third reaction play and create downfield.
Here we go. Big 13. First down. Here's Burrow. Throw left side, caught by the tight end, Hurst. Only a couple for him there on the game's first play, and it's second down.
Let's just make this one simple. Could he be any more open than he was on that play?
Yeah, they lost him going to the outside.
Hard to believe, because you go through your accounting on each and every defensive snap. Who's got who, what defense you're in. That was totally a blown coverage.
Now a throw downfield is taken in by his running back. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Going to fake to mix it and now look to throw. And the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. Micah Parsons just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Remember, they had the nice gain on the previous play, but they just gave a lot of it back right there on that sack.
Yeah, they get the sack, get back some real estate. Felt like the type of play that can spark a defense and swing some momentum. Almost felt like a take that type of a play, didn't it, partner?
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Eluding the pressure right. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a third down situation.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
Well, we can talk about it like it's just a basic route, but how about the timing on this one? Lined up on the right, runs a deep in route, and how about the throw? Right on the money. Bam, puts it right in there and on his hands. Nice completion, really good pickup.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Burrow will throw. This one hauled in by Sample. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
And Brandon, as you know, sometimes it's a lot tougher to run with these tight ends nowadays in the NFL. They're just bigger wide receivers. He lined up on the left side of the formation, ran a drag route across the field, and tried to work his way open. He was able to make the catch, but the defenders were there, couldn't do a whole lot with it afterwards.
The former second round pick, this is Joe Mixon. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
It's been a 7-play opening drive, and this is 3rd and short. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up, and he's going to have the first down at about the 38.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. This goes out wide for Mixon. Not much there, only a yard. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or the passing game, but they must like the matchups they're getting.
On 2nd down, here's Mixon, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. A gain of 2 there on the heels of a 1-yard pickup on 1st.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on 3rd down. From the shotgun, it's Burrow. And oh, that nearly an opening drive INT, but it does fall incomplete. Not the way you wanted to start this ball game, as it brings up 4th down. So on 4th down, off goes Burrow. On comes Evan McPherson for the Bengal field goal. This will be kicked from the 42. It's a 52-yard attempt. McPherson's kick is good. And the Bengals are on the board first here. It's 3-0. They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was hoping for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
Here's McPherson now to send it away. Pollard to return from the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25.
Now we'll see what the right arm of Dak Prescott has in store as the Dallas Cowboys offense sets up shop.
It's been a lot of fun watching him advance in his career. Many people question his ability to throw the football coming out of Mississippi State. He's conclusively answered that question. In addition, a very strong runner and an even better leader.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. Prescott. Open man right side, it's Lamb. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Looked like man coverage, able to read it there on the outside for the completion. That'll be something to track as the game goes along here.
It certainly will, and there's so many different ways that they will try to figure out whether they're in man or zone. Sometimes you'll run a guy in motion to see if someone runs with him. Other times you'll empty out the backfield, spread it out, and see if everyone comes out and matches up. In any event, anytime you see man coverage, you tell your guys you've got to win those matchups, because if you do, you'll get the football and probably for a nice game.
His defense might want to wake up on this drive and stop him before that first down marker.
Unfortunately, it's easy to grade the defense right now. Not good. Three plays, three first downs. They've got to come up with something to slow them down.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. This is Elliott. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
Oh, and now he bowls him over. And they'll get eight out of this before being stopped at the 28. 3-0 after one on EA Sports. Eight yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Off the play fake, Prescott. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
Prescott. And his ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. It's a 6-yard touchdown pass, and the Cowboys have taken the lead. And they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller, but they've retained their quickness and their speed. It's a lethal combination.
Always good to have wide receivers with height. Chris Nagar now for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
Brandon Wilson to return it. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Cincinnati coming back onto the field here for their second drive.
And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. They're passing here, Joe Burrow. Flush to his right. Now Burrow loses the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys. Huge, huge play by the defense, not only to force the fumble, obviously, but to return it for a touchdown.
And I know it's no fun for anyone who plays offense, but isn't it fun to see how a defense rallies when there's a fumble return and everyone tries to find someone to block and bring it all the way home?
I always like their celebrations because they don't get there that often.
No, they're not choreographed very well usually.
Nagar now for the point after.
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way, the fumble return for a touchdown. So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score.
This taken in at the goal line. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line.
Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here.
They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. Play action now, Burrow. Man open, that's Ja'Marr Chase complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Had to put that ball in there with a little extra zip, and he put it right where it needed to be.
Yeah, and that little extra pace that he had on the pass, that required a little extra concentration for him, didn't it? Ball can get on you pretty quick in that manner, and he handled it well and picked up the first down.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. Now Burrow. A full 5 yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough.
Thank you. two. Ready?
Check. Hit the five.
Here's Burrow. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete.
You definitely would have liked to have hit on that one, because now you've got a third and long showing up, and you just know defense is going to be getting after it. They are pinning their ears back, and they are coming.
The Bengals on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 15. Now it's Burrow. To Mixon on the check down. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. 3 yards all they could muster there, and it'll bring up 4th down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a 4th down?
The Bengals bring out their punter now, as he's on here to punt it away. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. 2nd drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. And that last drive, so effective in the passing game, resulting in the touchdown. Maybe not many people were focused on the trenches. There was good protection there.
Excellent protection. So now defensively, you've almost got to get down to those starters blocks like you're a sprinter. Get lower than those guys on offense and find a way to roar through them or around them to get into the face of the passer.
Easier said than done, though.
Way easier said than done. But they've got to try something, because right now they're just cutting them to shreds.
They'll start the drive with Elliott. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On 2nd and 7, Prescott got an open man. It's Michael Gallup.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. To throw is Prescott. Left side to Lamb. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a 1st and 10 at the 44-yard line. The give is to Elliott. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Meanwhile, Prescott's throw complete into the hands of Schultz here. And he's got another 1st down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 30.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football, and that's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Prescott on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Lamb. A gain of six there on first. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Second and four. Out of the gun. Here's Prescott. And he'll go right back to Lamb. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line. From the red zone now, Prescott. Touchdown, Cowboys! Two first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment and you have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
The guard now for the extra point. And it's 21-3. So that drive takes him down the field in eight plays. And it's capped off with a Cowboys touchdown. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Wilson now on the return. A solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32. The Bengals going to take over late in this first half. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get three out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a two-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle. Dumps it off to Mixon, and he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
To throw again on second down, Burrow. He completes it to Boyd. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half.
Here we go.
They will throw on first down with Burrow. He will find his man Chase complete. The Bengals going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. Yeah. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Throwing again, it's Burrow. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away, but could not. Micah Parsons able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. They'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. This will be spotted just shy of midfield, a 59-yard attempt. McPherson's kick is good, and that'll get the deficit down to 15. So as it turns out, that sack doesn't wind up costing them, Charles. They at least get points, get three of them.
Yeah, that's where your kicker can really come to your rescue because, you know, after the sack, there was a little consternation there. Are we out of field goal range? Are we going to be able to get three? In this case, he stepped right up and gave them exactly what they needed.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. So time perhaps for one final kneel down before they take this lead to the locker room. The final second ticks by, and that's going to do it for the first half of play. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports halftime report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome everyone to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has certainly been one-sided to this point. It's a two-touchdown difference, as the teams have already come back out onto the field for the second half. So let's get you back out as well to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. Pollard elects to keep it, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Out comes CeeDee Lamb and the rest of the Dallas offense, and he is closing in on the 100-yard mark for the day.
And it appears that he loved the fact that they're going to play this game earlier. You know, daytime, he's out there running around, feeling good about himself. Whatever his prep was coming in, he was able to get out there quick and fire away.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. On the option, here's Elliott. Oh, Zeke with a quick feet. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Throwing, Prescott. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. We talk a lot about setting the tone to start the game. Well, you want to start the tone right in the third quarter as well, and nearly lost a football there in their first drive.
And sometimes we overdo it when we talk about halftime adjustments and what teams are going to do. Most of the time, it's just a matter of executing the game plan you brought in. But I'll guarantee you, they didn't draw that play up on the whiteboard at halftime. They're fortunate to retain possession.
The good news, they kept the ball. Bad news, it's third and long. Here's Prescott. And he is caught by Lamb. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big play that time on the catch and run.
That's a real nice job right there, working the middle of the field, working against those safeties. And you know, partner, if you get your hips turned the wrong way, big plays can result.
And a big play resulted right there. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Prescott to throw it. He finds his target. It's Schultz. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
And this is caught off a deflection. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four.
But when we see the ball tipped in the air, sometimes we get a little roll change, don't we? Because when it's in the air, sometimes the defensive back becomes the receiver. And in this case, the receiver looked like a defensive back, but ended up a receiver.
He caught it as a receiver. Hey, it worked out.
Worked out really well for them. But I'm telling you, the defensive guys.
Frustrated.
Oh, frustrated. They're going to catch it in film.
They'll have to deal with a second and 14 now after the loss. Now Prescott. To the right side, incomplete to Washington. Heck of a broken tackle and able to work this down near the 23. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
When you decide to run a hitch route, it really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
They'll throw again. Prescott. He's going to find Gallup here complete. And he will have a Cowboys first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
All right, let's just go ahead and walk through this one pretty easily, right? Blast off the line of scrimmage, get downfield to a certain point, usually around 8 to 10 yards, turn around and make sure the quarterback sees your numbers and set yourself up for the pass.
A well-executed curl route by Charles Davis. First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. A handoff left, Elliott. And he's got this inside the 10 to the 9 before he's out of bounds. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. Zeke going to get it on the option. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, a 9-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, that's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
An extra point by Nagar is up and good. And the lead opens up now to 22 points. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. The return man, Wilson. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Burrow and the Bengals with a first and 10 at their own 26. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. They'll roll him out right. Breaks the tackle, now an alley. And Burrow going to slide to the ground as he does pick up the first down.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice gain.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Burrow going to give this to Mixon. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run. So I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got a chance to pin their ears back and get after him now.
Final minute now of the third quarter. To throw on second and six. Burrow. Open man is Higgins. That catch good for five. It's third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. And he's got Hurst, his tight end. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. Now it's Mixon running right. And despite the good footwork, he'll be hit and dropped shy of the 45. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Burrow looking to pass. He'll drop this one down to Mixon. And the stiff arm made it a pretty little run. Not a huge gain, but a nice chunk of yardage. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And the Bengals on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. Here it's third and two. Now it's Burrow. Open man, it's complete to Higgins. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 27-yard line.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
First down, here's Burrow. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. To the air again, Burrow. And that's going to be caught, T. Higgins. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Finally, a first red zone opportunity for these guys. They've got a first and 10 from the 10. A carry here for the big tight end. And he bowls his way into the end zone for a Bengal touchdown. Hayden Hurst, a 10-yard touchdown run. And the Bengals are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. All right, so this one not quite over yet. Back to a two-score game, CD.
Yeah, and you've still got four-plus minutes to go, so when you think about comebacks, it's happened before. Now, it hasn't happened often, but you've got to think to yourself, let's be the next great comeback story and play this one out.
Here we go, so now the Bengals' offense will stay out there as they'll decide to go for two. Let's get it together, defense. And Burrow's going to look to throw for it. And he's got it for the two-point conversion. So they tack on a pair more here to narrow that deficit a bit further. So they elect to pass there on the two-point try. Sometimes could prove risky there. It worked out.
Yeah, and I love how you bring up that it can prove risky, because if you get it intercepted and they return it, that's 2 points for the defense, but not on that play.
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. Pollard to return from the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result had he opted for the touchback. Out comes CeeDee Lamb and the rest of the Dallas offense.
And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
7 yards, the pickup there.
And that's why defensive coaches preach swarming to the football. It's usually going to take more than one guy to get that big man down.
And it did right there. Multiple broken tackles, but they eventually get him down. Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott. He's got his man. It's Gallup. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
Partner, I like that they're staying aggressive on offense because, to me, this drive is what is known as a put-away drive. You score here, that might put this one to bed. I like the fact that they're playing with confidence and not playing with fear.
Try to run some clock now with Elliott. Able to fight through one tackle. And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. Give him 5 on the carry there and it'll be second down.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We've got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Elliott going to get it again on second down. It'll be a gain of 2, and speaking of twos, it'll take us to the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a 3rd down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away.
And they'll try and run the option to pick it up.
And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Tenth carry now for Elliott. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. So they come up on 2nd down. If they can get another run like we just saw, would likely put an end to this thing. Again, it's Elliott. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Now the Bengals going to signal for their 3rd and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the 1st down. We'll see if the defense wants to stop it as they take the knee. If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up 2nd down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. 68 yards on the ground for him so far. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Prescott, he goes down to a knee, and that should just about do it.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Cowboys as we sign off and say so long from Arlington.